找那个人，他就。
So,
我们等麦克风 settle down 回头再开始吗？
他来就走，不要把它放大放大，给它放开。
Many of you here know who I am.
来，我们大家一起来祷告。
No, not yet. I just want to introduce myself.
Okay. 我现在想向大家介绍一下我自己。
So, my name is Patrick. If you don't know.
如果你不知道的话，我的名字是 Patrick。
So I do the English ministry here. I also teach the youth.
我在这里有一个英文的施工，我也教我们的青少年们。
And I'm very excited. Often I get to speak to the Mandarin community.
像中文堂来讲到的时候，我总是很激动的。
You know, when I speak to the Mandarin-speaking portion of our church, it's just like going back to China.
当我向中文堂讲到的时候，就像回到中国一样。
This song, Rock Rock Jesus Christ.
刚刚我们唱的这首歌《磐石磐石耶稣基督》
，It reminds me of doing ministry in China.
让我回想到我在中国做事工的时候。
It's a very popular song.
在当地是一个非常非常流行的歌。
When you hear it, you can feel like God's angels are watching.
当你唱这首歌的时候，你能感觉到神的众天使正在看着你。
Caring for us, protecting us.
众天使保守着我们，看顾着我们。
So it just moves my heart.
使我的心非常感动。
I've been in many churches before where people sing this song and everyone is crying.
我到过很多教会，大家唱这首歌的时候，很多人感动流泪。
And they are very emotional.
很多人非常非常情绪化。
So I know that it's a song that God uses to touch people's hearts.
所以我知道神用这首歌来触动每一个人的心。
Also, my wife Iris, it's one of her favorite songs.
这也是我太太 Iris 最喜欢的一首歌之一。
And so when we were thinking about what to teach, I always ask my wife, it's a good habit to ask your wife.
当我唱歌的时候，讲到的时候，我总是问我太太，问太太总是一件很好的事情。
And she says you should teach about the rock of Jesus Christ.
这次她告诉我，你应该教导大家耶稣是我们的磐石。
And we can name it after the song.
所以我们就把我们今天的讲道叫做这首歌的名字，磐石磐石耶稣基督。
So there are a few things I want to show you in my message today.
今天我想跟大家说一些事。
When I teach, I have a unique style.
当我讲道的时候，我有一个特别的形式。
I don't teach like a college professor.
我不像一个大学教授一样教。
So I don't have a beginning, a middle, an end, and then like a quiz.
我不会有开始、中间、结束，也没有一个汤堂的考试。
It's nice if you take notes, but I'm not going to test you afterward.
给大家如果想写下什么，可以，但是结束以后不会考试。
So when I teach, what I want to do is show all of you how much God loves me and God loves you.
当我讲到的时候，我希望向大家显明神多么的爱大家，爱我，也爱你们。
Of course, I'm not perfect.
当然我不完美。
Nobody that teaches in front of the church is a perfect person.
教会教导大家的人没有一个是完美的。
In the whole world, there is no perfect preacher.
整个世界也没有任何人是完美的。
But all I can do is tell you about God's love.
我能做的就是告诉大家神多么的爱你。
And then when you hear me tell you about God's love,
当你听到我告诉大家神如何爱你们，
think about how God loves you.
想一想神是怎么样爱你的。
How God loves your family, your friends.
神怎样爱你的家人，你的朋友。
All the things that have happened in your past that have brought you to where you are.
过去的事，在过去的生命中神如何带领你，怎样带领到你到今天。
Maybe all of us here wish we were in a more successful position.
也许今天我们所有人都希望我们能够更成功。
It's possible we have regrets and sometimes when we made a bad choice.
可能我们有遗憾，有的时候我们做的决定并不那么明智。
But the good news is we're all here today.
好消息是我们今天都在这里，在神的家中。
Here with God.
我们与神同在。
The reason I joined this church was because I could feel God's love and God's Holy Spirit in this church.
我来到这个教会的原因是我可以感觉到神的爱，我可以感觉到圣灵的同在。
And so as I teach today, think about God's love in this church.
当我讲到的时候，请大家想一想神的在这个家，神在这个教会中的爱。
God has made the foundation of this church, and God will keep this church building higher and higher.
神已经成了这个教会的基石，神会不断地建造这个教会。
As long as we focus on God's rock.
如果我们定睛仰望神，神是我们的磐石。
Jesus Christ.
我们的磐石就是耶稣基督。
So, when I was beginning to collect the verses I wanted to talk about, I got very excited.
当我准备讲道的时候，在搜集各种经文，我非常激动。
I got so excited that I probably put too many verses in a PowerPoint.
我特别激动，于是我放了太多的经文在我的幻灯片里面。
When I sent the PowerPoint and the notes to Ning, she said, can you please maybe take out some of the verses?
当我把这个幻灯片寄给丽宁的时候，丽宁跟我建议，你能不能减少一些经文？
And I said, I tried to already take out some verses, but I can't find any I don't want to use. I want to use all of them.
我说我已经试图减少了，但是我这里面每一个经文都有用。
So I'm going to move very quickly.
所以我今天会讲得很快。
I don't want you to feel stressed.
我不想让你感觉到太压力太大。
This is not a new message.
这不是一个新的信息。
This is an old message.
这是一个老的信息。
Jesus taught this message.
耶稣在这个信息之中。
Paul and Peter taught this message.
保罗和彼得也说过这个信息。
So for all of us, this is a reminder of how great God is.
对我们所有人来说，这对我们来说是一个提示提醒。
Be encouraged.
让我们大家都能够得到鼓励。
Be reminded.
让我们大家都得到提醒。
And as we move through the verses, don't feel stressful if you can't catch up.
当我们不断的讲过经文的时候，请大家不要觉得压力太大，要跟上。
Listen for God.
仔细的聆听神要对你说什么。
Hold tight to God.
紧紧的抓住神。
And carry this message through your week, through your month, and through your year.
整个这一个星期、这一个月、这一年，都紧紧的抓住这个信息，思考这个信息。
This is a message about all of us.
这是一个关于我们所有人的信息。
So let's move to the first slide.
所以我们去看第一章。
Okay. Let's read this together.
我们一起来读。
Go ahead and read the Mandarin.
我们大家可以一起来读那个中文。这个看一下。我必在河列的磐石那里站在你面前，你要击打磐石，从磐石里必有水流出来，使百姓可以喝。摩西就在以色列的长老眼前这样行了。出埃及记十七章。
So we know this story.
我们都知道这个故事。
Let me start with the basics.
我们从最基本的来讲起。
We know that in the desert, Moses was leading the people, and they were angry and thirsty.
我们知道摩西带大家经过旷野，大家都非常的生气，非常的饥渴。
They were very, very frustrated with Moses.
他们对摩西非常失望。
And what they wanted was they just wanted a little water. They wanted to know God cared for them.
他们只是需要一点点水，需要知道神对他们是一直关怀照顾着。
So we know the story. Moses prayed, and God told Moses to go find this rock, and then strike the rock, and the water will come out.
我们都知道这个故事。神叫摩西去找到一个岩石，击打岩石，水从岩石中流出来。
So Moses went and he found the rock God was talking about, and he hit the rock and water came out. It's a miracle.
所以摩西去找到这个岩石，击打岩石，水从岩石中流出来。
So let me let you in on a secret.
我告诉大家一个秘密。
A secret to read the Bible.
怎么样能够读懂圣经的这个诀窍
？Easy answer. What's the topic of the New Testament?
特别容易的解释就是新约到底讲的是什么呢
？Anyone know? Jesus. Jesus. Everyone say Jesus.
每个简单的说。
Jesus.
耶稣。
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 The topic of the New Testament.
耶稣就是新约的主题。
What's the topic of the Old Testament?
旧约的主题是什么呢？
耶稣。
耶稣。
Jesus is the topic of the Old Testament.
耶稣也是旧约的主题。
All of the world, all of creation, and everything in the Bible points to Jesus.
全世界整个创造所有一切圣经中记载的，叫我们指向耶稣。
So when we read the Old Testament, we're looking for Jesus.
当我们读旧约的时候，我们要寻找耶稣。
So in this story, who's Jesus?
在这个故事中，谁是耶稣呢？
Two people, two things.
两件事情。
Moses is Jesus.
摩西预表了耶稣。
And the rock is Jesus.
磐石代表了耶稣。
Moses is Jesus because Moses is a leader of the people.
摩西预表耶稣，因为摩西是人们的领袖。
He is the spiritual leader.
他是属灵的领袖。
And he talks to God for the people.
他代表神向人们说话。
This is what Jesus is doing for us today.
耶稣今天也仍然向我们说话。
Moses took the people from being slaves and being captives to being free.
摩西带领人们离开囚禁和作为奴役之地。
Moses led the people to the promised land.
摩西带领人们进入应许之地。
This is a picture of Jesus and a picture of heaven.
就像我们预表了耶稣和天堂。
But the rock is also Jesus.
但是磐石也代表了耶稣。
The rock gives living water.
磐石给我们活水。
Jesus gives water to us.
耶稣也给我们活水。
It can change their lives and save them.
这活水可以改变生命，拯救我们。
The rock is supernatural, full of miracles, and so is Jesus.
磐石是属天的，充满了神迹耶稣也是如此。
So think about this as we move forward.
当我们往前走的时候，请思考这个问题。
So again, we see another rock that is another miracle.
我们看到另外一个磐石，另外一个神迹。
You can read this verse.
我们大家一起来读这一段，在民数记二十十一啊，摩西举手，用杖击打磐石两下，就有许多水流出来，会众和他们的牲畜都喝了。
Another secret about the Bible.
另外一个读圣经的诀窍。
Any good thing God will tell us more than one time.
如果神告诉我们关于某件事多于一次的话
，All miracles happen more than once.
所有的神迹都会不止一次的发生。
In our lives today, everything good in our life, God will tell us multiple times.
今天在我们生命中美好的事物，神会多次的向我们提说。
When God says something, He says it always and forever. It's His promise.
当神说话的时候，他说这总是如此，也这是他的应许。
So we are to be reminded of God.
我们在这里会被提醒关于神的事情。
And the Israelites were also reminded of God.
以色列人也因此被提醒关于神的事情。
We know this example, we know this story. Moses made a mistake and felt prideful, and because of this, he could not go to the promised land.
我们知道这件事情，摩西犯了一个错，因着这个不顺服，摩西不能进入应许之地。
But God blessed the people anyway.
但是神仍然祝福那些人，虽然摩西犯错。
Even when Moses was not perfect and made a mistake, God still caused the miracle.
尽管摩西并不完美，犯了一个错，神仍然看顾保守这些人进入应许之地。
When your work or your family is falling apart around you, if you hold to God, you will be blessed.
当你的工作、你的家庭都发生了巨大的变化，受到冲击。你仔细的紧紧抓住耶稣，神会继续的祝福你。
There were people who were seeking after God, even though Moses made a mistake. The people still got the blessing from Jesus.
人们就不管怎么样，有些人紧紧的抓住耶稣，他们还是会受神的祝福。
The living water from the rock in the desert.
我们要认识荒漠中给予我们活水的磐石。
God will do what God's going to do. He always does.
神会做他要做的，他总是会完成他的计划。
Even if we don't join him,
尽管我们不与他同工。
God doesn't need us, we need God.
神不需要我们，我们需要神。
But we don't want to miss on his blessings.
但我们不想错过他的祝福。
You share an example.
让我跟大家分享一个例子。
So you have a family.
有一家人。
In the family, it's time to cook supper, so the parents are cooking supper.
在家里面总是父母来烧饭。
And the older brother is helping cook supper and helping set the table.
大哥哥呢就帮忙整理桌子。
And the younger sibling, a little boy, he has a choice.
小弟弟呢就有个选择。
He could be with the family and help the family prepare the supper, even though he's not very useful. He can be with them.
他可以帮忙这个家准备这个晚饭，尽管他并不能帮多少。
The family doesn't need him to make a good supper.
整个全家并不需要他帮忙来烧饭。
But they want the relationship, they want their family together.
但是这个家非常重视全家在一起啊，建立关系。
So maybe they give him some small jobs, little things to do to help.
所以家里面人会给这个小弟弟一点点小小的事情来帮忙。
Here you can take chopsticks to put them on the table.
这里请拿那个筷子放在桌子上。
And now take all the bowls of rice. Be careful, they're very hot.
啊，去拿一些饭，把它放在那里，当心这个饭很热。
Of course they could do it, but they let the little boy do it because they want to participate as a family.
当然家人可以做 这件事情，但是他们想让小孩子做，让他可以在家庭中做些什么。
When it's time to eat, they all eat together.
当晚饭的时候，他们一起在一起吃饭。
Now what if the little boy doesn't want to participate?
如果这小弟弟不想加入这些事情怎么办呢？
He's going off to play in his room.
他可以到他房间去玩。
And maybe he goes to play outside.
或者在外面玩。
Right? It's difficult when it's time to eat to find the little boy.
到吃饭的时候很难找到这个小孩，就不知道他在哪里。
The parents and the brother have to look for him and get him to come back from his room from outside and stop doing the other things and it's time to eat.
父母或者大哥哥会到房间里或者外面把他找回来，还告诉他到了吃饭的时候。
And if they can't find him, then they feel very stressed and the food may go bad because they're looking for the child.
如果他们找不到他们，他们大家都会很着急，因为晚饭要凉了，找不到他来吃饭。
So of course.When the child is with the family, the child can have the blessings of the family.
当然，当这个小弟弟和全家同在的时候，这小弟弟就得到了和家人一起同在的祝福。
But if you're not with the family, you can miss out on the blessings.
如果你不和家人同在，你当然就错失了所有的这些祝福。
If we're with Jesus, we have blessings.
如果我们与耶稣同在，我们就得到祝福。
We don't want to miss on the blessings.
我们不想错过与神同在的祝福。
So now to the New Testament.
我们看新约。
Paul is explaining the same meaning of the rock in the Old Testament.
保罗在这里解释关于岩石的这个意义。
Read together.
我们一起来读哥林多前书十章二到四节。好，都在云里海里受洗归了摩西，并且都吃了一样的灵食，也都喝了一样的灵水，所喝的是出于随着他们的灵磐石，那磐石就是基督。
So Paul, because of the Holy Spirit, wrote these words.
圣灵在圣灵的帮助下，保罗写下了这些话语。
Explaining the same idea.
解释同样的这个意思。
In the Old Testament,
在旧约中
there was a rock with a miracle water.
在旧约中有一个磐石，里面会奇迹般的出水，流出水来。
In the New Testament, we have Jesus.
在新约里面，我们有耶稣。
Now.This story is not about being baptized. This teaching today is not about being baptized, but I want to share something.
但是这个故事并不是关于受洗，今天的教导也不是关于受洗。
Where does baptism come from?
受洗洗礼这件事从哪里来的呢？
It comes from Jesus. Before Jesus, who was baptizing?
从耶稣之前谁受洗了？
John the Baptist. But before John the Baptist, where was baptism?
施洗约翰之前我们有没有洗礼？
The baptism was already in the Old Testament.
洗礼已经在旧约中了。
When the people came from Egypt, the Jews came from Egypt through the Red Sea, Paul says they were baptized.
当犹太人从出埃及的时候经过红海保罗说他们被施洗了。
Right here.
就在这里。
It also says they were baptized in the cloud.
他也说到在云里海里受洗。
What's the cloud?
云是什么？
It's the Holy Spirit.
是，就是圣灵。
Do you remember when the people were wandering in the desert? A cloud came down to the temple and showed them where to go.
你们记得在以色列人在旷野中走的时候有神派了一个云柱停在那个temple之上带领大家。
And so they were baptized. They were covered.Through the water and through the Spirit.
所以他们在水里，在灵里受洗。
In the New Testament, we teach the same teaching about baptism. You must be baptized in water and in the Spirit.
在新约里面，我们有同样的教导，你必须经过水洗，进入同洗于一灵。
Water is on the outside.
水是在外面的。
The Spirit is inside.
圣灵在你的里面。
Now, before this, there was also a baptism.
在这之前，圣经中还提到一处受洗。
The very first baptism in the Bible was the flood that destroyed the world.
圣经中第一个洗礼是挪亚方舟时代啊，毁灭世界的大水。
Moses and his family were baptized in the flood.
摩西和他挪亚和他的家 挪亚和他的全家在水中受洗。
Noah and his family. The important point is they went. They were covered by the water, and then they came on the other side alive.
这个意思就是说，他们整个进入啊，被浸入水中，在那边出来啊，全家都是啊啊啊安全。
So they were alive after the baptism.
他们施洗以后还活着。
When we baptize people underwater, they come back up alive.
我们啊给人施洗的时候，他们从水中起来与神同复活。
When Jesus died on the cross,
当耶稣死在十字架的时候
he died physical death.
他在肉体上经历一次死亡。
He wasn't pretending. He didn't just go to sleep. He died.
他没有假装，他不是睡觉了，他真的是死亡了。
And after 3 years, he came back to life.
三天以后，他又复活了。
After 3 days, he came back.
三天以后，他复活。
And so this is a picture of baptism.
这就是受洗的一幅图画。
The old is dead and the new has come.
旧事已过，都成为新的了。
And so we are baptized as a picture of this, a reminder of Jesus' sacrifice for us.
当我们受洗的时候，就提醒我们耶稣所为我们做出的牺牲。
So I just wanted to point out that baptism is talked about here by Paul, and then they talk about the water from the rock as Jesus Christ.
我们就想提醒大家，这里保罗所说的这个跟我们。刚刚所说的洗礼的意思是一样的，我们受洗啊，就归入这磐石耶稣。
All these ideas are connected.
所有的这些意思都是连接在一起。
Now moving to Revelation, it's a spiritual picture, a dream from John.
我们现在看启示录啊，约翰的这个意象。
Go ahead and read this one.
我们大家一起来读啊，这个启示录的这节经文啊，天使。又指示我在城内街道当中一道生命水的河，明亮如水晶，从神和羔羊的宝座流出来，在河这边与那边有生命树，结十二样果子，每月都结果子，树上的叶子乃为医治万民。
From the seat of God, the seat of Jesus, comes a river in heaven.
从神的宝座流出天堂的活水。
God says the important things many times.
神会把重要的信息不断地向我们诉说。
We see it repeated over and over in the desert in the New Testament, even in a picture of heaven.
你看这个信息不断地被重复，旧约中在荒漠中，然后又到了新约，保罗说，然后再到了启示录啊，约翰来说。
God says it again.
神又在这里再次诉说。
In John.
在约翰福音。
You can read this one.
我们大家一起来读约翰福音。唯有一个兵拿枪扎他的肋旁。随即有血和水流出来。
To check and make sure Jesus was dead, they used a spear to puncture his skin.
他们想查一查耶稣是不是真的死了，他们就拿矛去戳耶稣的肋旁。
And the Bible records that from his side came water and blood.
耶稣圣经记载耶稣的肋旁流出水和血来。
Everything that happens physically is a picture of something spiritually.
在身体上还在实际世界中发生的事情是属灵世界的一个影像和预表。
From Jesus comes water.
从耶稣那里流出水来。
Living water that saved the people in the desert.
活水，这活水曾经救了在旷野中的人们。
Living water he talked about when he talked to the woman at the well.
这个活水是他与在井旁的撒玛利亚妇人谈话时的水。
It's a positive blessing.
这是一个非常非常正面的信息和祝福。
From Jesus also flows blood.
从耶稣也流出血来。
Blood that is a sacrifice.
这个血就是耶稣为我们所做的牺牲。
Water makes us strong, it makes us healthy.
水让我们更强壮和更健康。
Blood is the reason we are not lost and dying, that we are saved.
水从耶稣流出血来，这就是为什么我们没有失丧，我们被拯救的原因。
From Jesus flows the blood to save us because of his sacrifice, and the water to save us with a new life.
从耶稣身上流出血来，能够拯救我们；从他的水流出水来，也是我们施洗得救。
These are all very simple teachings we've heard many times.
这些都是非常简单的教导，我们大家已经听了很多遍。
We can remember and be encouraged.
我可以不断地记得他，也受到鼓励。
Now moving back to the Old Testament, let's talk about another stone.
我们回到旧约来谈一谈另外一块石头。
I want to show you how often Jesus is hiding in the Old Testament.
我想啊，告诉大家啊，耶稣经常隐藏在啊旧约的很多信息中。
So, let's read this verse.
我们大家一起读这段撒母耳中的经节。大卫用手从囊中掏出一块石子来，用鸡血甩去，打中非利士人的头，石子进入囊内，他就扑倒，面伏于地。
David, we know, is a very special person in the Old Testament.
大卫，我们知道他是旧约中一个特别的人。
David represents Jesus as a king.
大卫预表耶稣，是做王的耶稣。
David represents Jesus as a worshipper because David loved to worship.
大卫预表耶稣是一个敬拜者，因为大卫非常喜欢敬拜。
David wrote many of the book of Psalms, and he sang and danced often. We read about it.
大卫写了诗篇中很多很多的诗篇，我们都经常读甚至唱。
And so David has a heart after God.
在圣经中大卫被称为合神心意的人。
Just like Jesus has a heart after God.
就像耶稣合神心意一样。
Who has a heart after God?
这里谁合神心意？请举手。
Raise your hands.
Who
wants a heart after God?
谁想要一个合神心意的心？
Yeah, we want it, don't we?
感谢主。
Amen.
Amen.
David has a heart after God.
大卫有合神心意的心。
So we see Jesus represented as David here.
我们就看到大卫预表耶稣。
And we also see a stone.
我们也看到一块石子。
Jesus is also the stone.
耶稣也是那一个石头。
Who defeated Goliath? Who killed Goliath in this battle?
谁打败了哥利亚？
God did it through the stone.
神通过石头打败了哥利亚巨人。
The army, they had armor, they had swords and great weapons.
整个军队有各种各种的武器刀剑。
They had strength and experience.
他们有力量，他们有经验。
From our human eyes, the enemy army looked very big and very deadly.
从我们人的肉眼看来，我们的敌人看起来多么的可怕，多么的就是难以战胜。
Impossible to defeat.
几乎不能战胜。
But David, we know the story. He was small. He was weak. He was young.
但我们知道这个故事中大卫很年轻也没有什么力量。
To defeat the enemy of God, he didn't need great weapons.
为了打败神的敌人，他不需要什么武器。
He defeated the enemy of God with a small stone.
他用一个小小的石子打败了神的敌人。
How?
怎么样做到的呢？
Because of faith.
因为他的信心。
We just need faith.
我们只是需要信心。
Anything coming against us will be defeated as long as we hold to God with faith.
无论怎么样和神相反的事情反对神的事情，我们都可以战胜他们，只要我们依靠信心，在信心中依靠神。
We don't need great wisdom and great experience and great weapons.
我们不需要多大的智慧、经验和武器。
We just need Jesus.
我们只是需要耶稣。
David had Jesus.
大卫有耶稣。
David, because of Jesus, was able to save the kingdom of Israel.
因为耶稣，因为这个大卫对神的信心，他可以拯救以色列。
Moses and David are just normal people.
摩西和大卫是。I'm sorry.
Normal, ordinary.
这只是普通人而已。
Who is an ordinary person here?
谁是一个普通人？
But do we want the blessings they had?
我们要他们的祝福吗？
Amen.
Amen.
We want Jesus.
谁要耶稣？
We can come against any enemy in the name of Jesus.
我们可以奉耶稣的名战胜所有的敌人。
Because of faith.
因为我们的信心。
Now, notice what happens next in the story.You can read this verse.
我们大家一起来读撒母耳记上这段经文啊。大卫跑去，站在非利士人身旁，将他的刀从鞘中拔出来，杀死他，割了他的头。非利士众人看见他们讨战的勇士死了，就都逃跑。
David didn't just throw the stone and say, "I win, I win," and ran away.
大卫没有只是扔一块石子，然后高高兴兴地说，我赢了，我赢了。
David ran over to the enemy.
大卫跑到敌人的身边。
He stood on top of the enemy.
他俯视看着这个敌人。
And he let everyone see that the Jewish people were victorious.
他让每一个以色列人都看见我们得胜了。
This is also a picture of Jesus.
这也是啊，一幅预表耶稣的图画。
What does David later write in Psalms? Right here.
大卫后来在诗篇里面写了什么呢？我们一起来读一下。
Read this verse.
诗篇八六啊，你派他管理你手所造的，使万物，就是一切的羊牛、田野的兽、空中的鸟、海里的鱼，凡惊醒海盗的，都伏在他的脚下。
We know that at the end of time, Jesus puts everything under his feet.
我们知道结束的时候，在万物结局的时候，神使一切的仇敌伏在耶稣的脚下。
Except for God.
除了神以外。
And then he gives everything under his feet victoriously to God.
他把所有在他脚下的一切就是得胜的一切献给神。
Here we see this happening as well.
我们这里看到这件事在发生。
The stone of Jesus defeated the enemy.
耶稣的石子战胜了敌人。
And then David represents Jesus, put the enemy under his feet.
大卫预表耶稣使仇敌伏在他的脚下。
We want to be friends of Jesus.
谁想做耶稣的朋友呢？
So think about Jesus the warrior.
我们想一想耶稣这个战士。
Read this verse.
我们来读哥林多前书的这节经文。在后，末期到了。那时基督即将一切执政的、掌权的、有能的都毁灭了，就把国交与父神，因为基督必要作王。等神把一切仇敌都放在他的脚下，尽末了所毁灭的仇敌就是死。
We can defeat some enemies. We can defeat some.
我们可以打败一些敌人。
But Jesus, God, can defeat all.
但是耶稣神可以打败所有的敌人。
Even something impossible to do.
甚至可以完成一些不可思议的事情。
They can even defeat death.
他们可以使毁灭了死亡。
We are saved from death because of Jesus the warrior.
我们从死里被拯救，因为耶稣这个战士。
We see this happening in the Old Testament. We see it taught in the New Testament, and it's happening right now in our lives.
我们看这个信息被在旧约中教导，在新约中也教导，我们今天也看见这个信息。
All the important blessings are repeated over and over and over.
所有重要的这些祝福不断的在被重复。
Go back to Isaiah in the Old Testament. He's a prophet.
我们回到以赛亚，旧约中的以赛亚。
Let's read this verse.
我们一起读这段以赛亚书中的经文。他必作圣所，却像以色列两家做绊脚的石头，跌人的磐石，像耶路撒冷的居民作为圈套和网罗。
When God told Isaiah to write these words, Isaiah may not have known about Jesus. He just knew about these words.
当神叫以赛亚写这些经文的时候，以赛亚可能并不知道耶稣，他只知道神预示默示给他的这些经文。
A stumbling rock.
一个绊脚石。
It's a mystery to the Jewish people.
这个绊脚石对犹太人来说是一个秘密，是一个奥秘。
Look forward to Paul in Romans. He talks about the same topic.
我们看这个保罗在新约里面，他讲到同样的信息。
Go ahead and read this one.
那我们一起来读这一段罗马书中的经文。但以色列人追求律法的义，反得不着律法的义，这是什么缘故呢？是因为他们不凭着信心求。只凭着行为求，他们正跌在那绊脚石上。
It's not following the law that saves them; it's faith.
你遵守律法并不能使你得救。
Just like David was saved through faith.
就像大卫是因信得救。
We are saved through faith.
我们因信得救。
We can remember we are saved not by hard work but by faith.
我们可以记得，我们不是通过努力得救，而是通过信心得救。
Let me tell you a story about Edward.My son, 1 year old.
让我来告诉你一个我一岁的儿子 Edward 的故事。
What is a stumbling stone?
什么是绊脚石？
Edward, I think he's very smart.
Edward, 我觉得他非常聪明。
But, he falls down all the time.
但是他不断跌跤。
He likes to look at what he wants. He sees something over there and he begins to walk to that thing.
他想看他要的东西，他看到那件东西在那里，他就向那件东西走过去。
If there's something in the way, like a table or a chair, he moves around the table and moves around the chair to go to the thing.
如果在那件事情之前，他会看见桌子和椅子，他会绕过桌椅。
But if there is something on the ground, he doesn't care. He doesn't look at it. He just falls down.
如果地上有些什么东西，他看不见，他就直接被那些绊倒，跌在地上。
And keeps looking at the thing.
不断的还在看着那件他想要的东西。
Gets back up.
然后站起来。
And he goes again and falls down.
他不断地向那件东西走过去，又一次跌倒。
Always looking at what he wants.
不断地看着那件东西。
So in this way, the Jewish people were focusing on God, focusing on heaven, but they missed Jesus.
同样的啊，犹太人啊，就眼睛专注于他们想要的天堂，而啊，忘却了耶稣。
They couldn't get forwards because of stumbling over something.
他们不能往前不断的行进，因为他们不断的被跌啊跌倒绊倒。
Something was Jesus.
这个绊脚石是耶稣。
But they didn't know.
但他们不知道。
Do we know?
我们知道吗
？Yes.
我们知道。
We should know.
我们应该知道。
Look back to Job. Job is one of the oldest books of the Bible. It was written before Moses wrote his five books.
我们来看啊，约伯记。约伯记是圣经中最古老的一本书，甚至在摩西五经之前就已经写好了。
The Israelites in Egypt would read and hear about the story of Job very often.
啊，以色列人常常听说，常常读，常常听说约伯的故事，经常听说。
Read this verse.
我们来读这段啊经文，约伯记中，啊。我立大地根基的时候，你在哪里？你若有聪明，只管说吧；你若晓得，就说。是谁立地的尺度？是谁把准绳拉在其上？地的根基安置在何处？地的脚石是谁翻放的？那时，晨星一同歌唱，神的众子也都欢呼。
Another stone.
啊，另外一个石头。
In the last sentence there, there was a cornerstone.
在最后一句话说到脚石。
The cornerstone is where you decide how to build the foundation.
啊，脚石就是你在哪里要啊建造你的基础。
If you have a strong, straight cornerstone, then you can have a strong, great, straight foundation.
你有一个很强的、很啊、很有力的这个啊防脚石，那么你的房子的基础就会打得很好。
Then your house will be stronger and it won't fall down as easily.
你的房子就会很坚固，不会轻易的倒塌。
So we know Job. We know his house fell down.
看，我们知道约伯，我们知道他全家最后都倒了。
Job is talking with God here, and God is talking about the idea of a cornerstone.
啊，约伯与神在对话，神在说这个脚石的故事，是。
Not for Job's house, cornerstone.
这个脚石并不是这个约伯的家的脚石。
The cornerstone of creation, the cornerstone of the world.
创造和全世界的脚石。
And notice the last line.
我们注意最后一节。
When God set the cornerstone down, all of the stars were singing and the angels were shouting with joy.
当啊最后一节说到地的脚石神安放在那里的时候，晨星欢唱，晨星歌唱，神的众子也都欢呼。
We know this is about Jesus.
我们知道这是关于耶稣的。
That's because we know Jesus.
因为我们知道耶稣。
If you didn't know Jesus, this just looks like a strange verse.
如果你不知道耶稣，这句话简直是难以理解。
For many years, they were looking at verses like this, and they had no idea it was pointing to Jesus.
成千上百年来，以色列人看着这节经文，并不知道这讲的是耶稣。
Why would the stars sing and the angels shout for joy for a rock? It's not a rock.
晨星为何歌唱？神的众子为何欢呼？为了一颗脚石欢呼呢
？We see Jesus in the Old Testament.
我们在啊旧约中看到耶稣。
This verse about a cornerstone, and the verse about a stumbling stone, and the verse about from Psalms we'll read in a moment are mentioned many times in the New Testament.
这个关于脚石，还有啊防脚石等等等等这些啊，整个经文中讲的都是耶稣的事。
So quickly, I'll just show you where.
所以我很快的告诉你在哪里。
So here we talk about another verse in Isaiah, talking about the stone in Zion, a tested stone.
这里在以赛亚书又提到一块作为根基的石头
，a treasure cornerstone，
一个非常宝贵的防脚石
，that it is strong and cannot be broken，
很坚固不能够打碎。
And those of us that have built our house on this cornerstone do not need to panic。
我们如果把我们的家建造在这样的防脚石上，我们不需要惊慌。
In Psalms we see it again。
我们在诗篇中又看到防脚石。
Read this verse。
我们来一起读这诗篇幺幺八。我要称谢你，因为你已经应允我，又成了我的拯救。匠人所砌的石头，已成了房角的铜块石头。
In Matthew, we see that Jesus quoted these same verses, and then he said this.
马太福音中，我们看到耶稣就引用同样的经文，他说。
He talked about the stumbling stone, cornerstone, and the rejected stone.
他提到这个绊脚石、防脚石和背弃的石头。
And then he says,
然后他说
Go ahead and read it.
好，我们来读马太福音。所以我告诉你们，神的国必从你们夺去，赐给那能结果子的百姓。谁掉在这石头上，必要跌碎；这石头掉在谁的身上，就要把谁砸得稀烂。
A stone cannot be broken.
这个石头不能够打碎。
And anything that the stone comes on top of will be crushed.
石头掉在谁的身上，都会被啊打得稀烂。
Including Goliath in the Old Testament with David.
包括这个旧约中大卫所打败的哥利亚。
Including in the New Testament, death will be defeated under Jesus.
包括在新约中，死亡也会被耶稣打碎。
In Mark and in Luke, it says that the same thing was said in the same story.
在马可福音和路加福音中，同样的故事又在诉说着。
The rejected stone is actually the cornerstone.
匠人所弃的石头已成了房角的头块石头。
You should not stumble over it. You should build your house on it.
不要再被这块石头绊倒，请在这块石头之上建造你的家庭。
Now in Acts, this is a long verse. I'm going to let you guys read it over in Mandarin. Just a moment.
我们一起来读这《使徒行传》中这几句经文。我们一起哈，大家能看清楚吗？我们一起哈，叫使徒站在当中，就问他们说：“你们用什么能力，奉谁的名做这事呢？”那时彼得被圣灵充满，对他们说：“是民的官府和长老啊。”倘若今日因为在残疾人身上所行的善事，查问我们他是怎么得了痊愈，你们众人和以色列百姓都当知道，站在你们面前的这人得痊愈，是因你们所钉十字架，神叫他从死里复活的拿撒勒人耶稣基督的名。他是你们匠人所弃的石头，已成了房角的头块石头，除他以外别无拯救，因为在天上地没有赐下别的名我们可以靠着得救。他们见彼得约翰的胆量，又看出他们原是没有学问的小民，就稀奇，认明他们是跟过耶稣的。谢谢。
So this is a story Jesus tells about people renting a vineyard.
这个地方有一个故事，耶稣告诉我们人们租了一个葡萄园。
The rich man sends them, the owner sends a servant to go and collect the rent, collect part of the harvest.
这个葡萄园的主人去打发他的仆人去那些佃户那里收租。
And then the people who are renting, they destroy the first servant, the second servant, they beat them up, and then the third servant they kill.
这些佃户呢就打了第一个和第二个，到最后第三个仆人，他们这些佃户居然把他们杀了。
So the rich landlord says, I will send my son. I love him. He's my treasure. At least they will respect my son.
所以这个园子的主人就说，我这样派，我要派我的儿子去，我的儿子是我的珍宝，他们一定会珍惜我的儿子。
And the renters think to themselves, if we kill the son, we can have all the riches of the father.
这些佃户自己想着说，如果我们把儿子杀了，我们就可以拥有这个园子。
And the people say, Jesus, I hope this will never happen.
人们说，耶稣啊，我真不希望这件事情曾经发生过，或者将会发生。
And then Jesus says something interesting.
耶稣说了一些很有意思的事情。
He says, "Well, let me tell you about Isaiah."
耶稣说，我要让我来告诉你们以赛亚书中的一件事。
And he talks about a rejected cornerstone.
他就提到这个被弃的方角石。
Jesus did this often.
耶稣经常这样做。
Somebody would ask about a detail, and then he would just tell a story about something unrelated.
有人就会问一个非常小的细节，耶稣就会说一些似乎毫无关系的事。
Jesus had God's wisdom.
耶稣有神的智慧。
Jesus knew how to answer questions that people could not answer.
耶稣知道如何回答问题，而人们并不知道怎样回答这些问题。
And so here we see that some of the people felt like they were being blamed by Jesus and looked to arrest him, but they could not arrest him because they were afraid of the other people.
有些人看到什么耶稣几乎要被抓起来。
Jesus is presenting himself as the cornerstone.
耶稣就像房角的石头一样。
The foundation stone. We're almost finished.
基础做基础的这个房角石。
In 1 Corinthians, we learn about the foundation stone.
在哥林多前书中，我们学到房角石。
Paul is teaching that Jesus is the foundation stone.
保罗在教导我们啊，耶稣是奠基石。
That based on Jesus, the whole building is built.
整个房子建造于啊这个奠基石之上。
Nobody can replace Jesus as the foundation.
没人能取代耶稣这块奠基石。
It doesn't matter how big and amazing the building becomes, the foundation is always Jesus.
不论这个 building 有多么的巨大，多么的坚固，这个奠基石永远都是耶稣。
And then we see in Ephesians again with Paul.
我们看到以弗所书中保罗又在谈到奠基石的事情。
God always repeats his blessings more than once.
神不断的重复他的这个祝福。
Read the Mandarin.
我们一起来读以弗所书中说到的奠基石的经文。因为我们两下借着他被一个圣灵所感，得以进到父面前，这样你们不再做外人和客旅，是与圣徒同国，是神家里的人了，并且被建造在使徒和先知根基上，有基督耶稣自己为房角石，各房靠他联络得合适，渐渐成为主的圣徒，你们也靠他同被建造，成为神借着圣灵居住的所在。
I love this verse.
我非常喜欢这节经文。
Because in Jesus we are no longer foreigners.
因为在耶稣里面，我们不再是外人了。
你知道我知道一点点中文吗？
你知道 ？Do you know I know a little Chinese?
I'm changing. I know a little bit.
我知道一点点中文。
But. I don't know everything, but sometimes I can guess what people are talking about.
我不知道所有的中文，但是我能够猜你们在说什么。
In China, what am I?
中国我是谁呢？
外国人。A foreign person. A foreigner.
老外。
Right? And in America, what am I?
在美国我是谁？
美国人。But do you know, very often in this church, do you know what I hear people say?
你知道这个教会常常听到人们说我什么？
这个外国人，the foreigner, right? And all of us that have immigrated from another country, including my wife Iris, when you're in America, what do people call you?
我们这些从外地来的移民，人们怎么称呼我们呢？
Very often.
经常。
外国人。
外国人。
对不对？ Right?
Is it right?
Foreigner. Yeah.
是吗？外国人。
Right. Very often, all of us are referred to as foreigners.
经常我们这里被人称为外国人。
I don't like me.
我不喜欢被称作外国人。
Right, this is America. We're all American.
这是美国，我们都是美国人。
Even if you don't have a visa, you're still American.
尽管你可能没有这个签证，你还是美国人。
Right, there is a culture, an idea, this thing that brings us together.
有一个文化，有一个理念，把我们大家带到一起。
Right, and we have that because we are not citizens of countries. We are citizens of heaven.
我们可以这样说，因为我们不是这个某个国家的居民，而是天国的公民。
So we see the foundation. We see Jesus is the foundation, but we also see that we are not foreigners because we are a family together in one house.
我们看到这个基石，耶稣就是这个基础的房角石。我们不再是外乡人，客旅。我们因为耶稣，我们成为一家人。
I want to end today with a few verses from Peter.
现在我要结束了，但是我要以彼得的一些经文来结束今天的讲道。
If you want to hear this whole teaching again, just read these verses in Peter.
如果你想再听我的讲道，就把这些经文重新看一遍就可以。
This is the summary of everything I said today.
这是今天我说的所有的东西的总结。
Read together these few verses here.
我们来一起读彼得前书的这几句经文。主乃活石，固然是被人所弃的，却是被神所拣选、所宝贵的。你们来到主前。也就像活石被建造成为灵宫，做圣洁的祭司，借着耶稣基督奉献神所悦纳的灵祭。
Jesus is a living stone.
耶稣是活石。
It also says we are living stones because of Jesus.
这里也说到我们因着耶稣也是活石。
The things that we do are acceptable to God because of Jesus.
我们做的事情为神所悦纳，完全是因了耶稣基督。
We are holy priests. That means priests that are set apart. We are people of God, saints.
我们是圣洁的祭司，因为我们被特别分别拣选出来，成为神的这个祭司。
Baptized, dead to our old self, and new, a new life, a new beginning, a new start.
当我们受洗的时候，我们向老我死亡，我们在神里面成为一个新造的人。
Because of Jesus.
完全因为耶稣。
We are being built into a spiritual house.
我们被建造进入一个灵宫。
Where none of us are foreigners.
在这个灵宫神的家中没有一个人是外人。
If those of you have read the Bible, you know that Peter and Paul like to argue.
如果你们读过圣经，你们知道彼得和保罗非常喜欢争论。
I think they loved each other, but they also fought like brothers.
我知道他们彼此有耶稣基啊、有基督徒的兄弟债，但是他们也互相竞争，互相争论。
But here we see they agree. If they agree, then it must be important.
但这里我们看到他们彼此同意，当他们同意的时候，这肯定是一件很重要的事。
Read the next part here.
让我们来读下一段经文。因为经上说，看哪，我把所拣选、所宝贵的房角石安放在西安，信靠他的人必不至于羞愧。所以他在你们信的人就为宝贵，在那不信的人有话说：匠人所砌的石头已做了房角的头块石头，又说做了绊脚石头、跌人的磐石。他们既不顺从，就在道理上绊跌。他们这样半跌也是预定的。
This is everything I just said.
这就是我刚刚所说的所有一切的信息的总结。
We see the foundation stone.
我们看到这个基石。
The cornerstone.
房角石。
The stumbling stone.
绊脚石。
We see that Jesus is the stone that we are all built on.
我们知道耶稣是基石，我们都建造于其上。
I'm encouraged by this. Who's encouraged?
我觉得很受鼓励。在这里谁也觉得很受鼓励？通过这个经文。
We are not built on ourselves, we are built on Jesus.
我们不是自己建造自己，而是建造于耶稣基督之上。
That's very exciting.
这是非常令人激动的。
Now let's finish the teaching here.
现在我们可以结束今天的讲道。
Please read together.
我们一起来读这一段经文在彼得前书里面。
唯有
你
是被拣选族类，是有君尊的祭司，是圣洁的国度，是属神的子民。要叫你们宣扬那将你们出黑暗入奇妙光明者的美德。你们从前算不得子民，现在却做了神的子民；从前未曾蒙怜悯，现在却蒙了怜恤。
Because of Jesus, we are a chosen people.
因为耶稣，我们是被拣选的人们。
A royal priesthood.
是有君尊的祭司，圣洁的祭司。
A holy nation.
一个非常圣洁的国度。
A nation is a group of people.
我们这里一群人在这个圣洁的国度中。
We are all citizens and part of the nation of heaven.
我们都是整个天国的子民。
But we are also God's special possession, His treasure.
我们也是神所宝贵的，他的特别珍贵的珍宝。
We praise God because He is wonderful.
我们赞美神，因为他实在太奇妙了。
He takes us from the darkness and brings us to the light.
他使我们出黑暗入光明。
We were lost, but now we are found. We know this.
我曾失丧，但今天我们被寻回。
We were blind, but now we see.
我曾瞎眼，但今天我们的眼睛睁开。
We do not deserve mercy, but God gives us mercy anyway.
我们并不配得神的恩慈，但神给我们他的恩典。
God doesn't ask us to be perfect.
神没有叫我们完美。
He asks us to be with Him.
他让我们与他同在。
We want to be with Jesus.
我们应该想要与耶稣同在同行。
Amen.
Amen.
Let's all stand up.
让我们都站起来。
Let's pray this verse together.
我们来用这节经文来祷告。
Oh, I changed my mind.
Okay, 我改变了位置。
Everyone sit down.
每个人请坐下。
My fault, I'm sorry.
这是我的错，抱歉。
I want to point something out.
我想指出一些事情。
If you are currently an elder or a deacon of this church, please stand up.
如果你是长职，这个教会的长职，请站起来。
Currently an elder and a deacon, please stand up. If you have ever been, so everyone look around.
每个人，请你看一看周围。
If you have ever been a deacon or an elder in this church, please stand up.
如果你曾经是长职，也请你站起来。
So everyone look around there. More, yes.
每个人都看一看身边，还有没有漏了谁。
If you have ever volunteered to help us organize a church event, please stand up.
你曾经来这个义务为教会做一些工作吗？请你来站起来。
I know we have people that have helped us organize worship teams.
我知道有人在自愿来帮助我们组织。
Decorations.
打扮这个教会，还有食物。
Any of these boards on the wall.
所有这些非常漂亮的打扮。
Please stand up. Yes, Solomon, you too.
站起来。
If you brought your kids and your family members and your friends to church, you are helping the church with your car. Who did that?
如果你把你的家人朋友带到教会的话，你请你站起来。
Stand up.
请站起来。
Now everybody stand up.
现在所有人都站起来。
I want you to think about something. God is our foundation.
神是我们的基础。
Jesus is our foundation.
耶稣是我们的脚石。
Because of our faith, we are each a brick in the building.
因着我们的信心，我们每一个人都是这个灵根中的一块石头。
We have new members all the time.
我们总是有新的成员来到中间。
And sometimes people pass away or move.
有些时候，有些人去世，有些人离开我们。
The bricks are always changing.
石头不断的变化。
But the foundation of this building, of these people, is Jesus.
而这个灵工的基础总是耶稣，永不改变。
Raise your hands to God.
向神举手。
God, we love you.
神啊，我们爱你。
We agree we are your chosen people.
我们真的是知道我们是你所拣选的。
You said that you are our leader and our king.
你说你是我们的领袖，你是我们的君王。
You have made us a royal priesthood.
你使我们成了就是有君尊的祭司。
We are part of your nation.
我们是你神国中的一员。
And part of your family.
我们是神家的一员。
God, you are our father.
神啊，你是我们的天父。
We declare the praises of you over you all the time.
我们来敬拜你，不断的敬拜你。
We were lost, but now we are found.
我们前曾失丧，今被寻见。
You bring us from the darkness to the light.
你使我们出黑暗入光明。
You build us all together as a family.
你把我们建造合一，成为一家。
And a house, a temple, a home for you, God.
我们建成一个你的圣殿，是你的家。
You are so merciful.
你多么的仁慈。
Even when we are not perfect.
尽管我们不那么完美。
And we love you.
我们爱你。
We agree that you are our foundation.
我们知道你是我们的基石。
In the name of Jesus, we pray.
奉主耶稣基督的圣名祷告。
Amen.